less about God, more of God. Practicing the presence, and that's what I hope we do this morning. And one way to do that is through singing. So we're going to kind of start it off, but you'll be joining in a moment, okay? You could sing along if you want, too, if you know it.
Over my head, I hear music in the air. Over my head, I hear music in the air. Over my head, I hear music in the air. There must be a God somewhere.
Oh, when the world is silent,
I hear music in the air.
Oh, when the world is silent,
I hear music in the air.
Oh, when the world is silent,
I hear music in the air. There must be a God somewhere.
Here we go.
Over my head, I hear music in the air. Over my head, I hear music in the air. Over my head, I hear music in the air. There must be a God somewhere. I hear music in the air.
Now when I think of Jesus,
I hear music in the air.
Now when I think of Jesus,
I hear music in the air. There must be a God somewhere.
Everybody.
Over my head, I hear music in the air. Over my head, I hear music in the air. Over my head, I hear music in the air. There must be a God somewhere.
Hallelujah. You all did good too.
Well, it's here. This is my last day here. But so what I decided I wanted to do was to go out singing. Okay, so what we're going to do is I'm going to wrap a few reflections around singing today, but mostly be that. It won't be, as my daughter used to call it, sermonizing. She got me a t-shirt that said the sermonizer on it, right? So everyone knows this one. Let's rise and sing together. Holy, holy, holy. Standing, and just a couple announcements. One is there's not a finance meeting this week, right? And right. The Bible study, hopefully the Tuesday morning will start again soon. Although, are you keeping it going? You got anything planned, Barbara? No? Not at this point? Those are the only two announcements.
There's one more, Bob.
What's that?
Yeah, Betsy Merkel has sort of reorganized the reunion group for Emmaus persons. So this Tuesday at 4:00 down in the fellowship hall, we'll be gathering. So if you are part of that Emmaus group or you'd like to find out a little more about Emmaus, we'll see you at 4:00 this Tuesday downstairs.
Let us join Bill in our praise to God this morning.
Praise to you, O gracious one. Blessed are those who reverence the Holy One, who delight in love consciousness,
Abundance and wholeness will be our heritage, and truth will be our banner.
Light penetrates their darkness. Love stands by them with mercy and forgiveness.
And we become co-creators with the Divine One, blessing the world with presence in us.
We'll be singing two hymns out of the Faith We Sing hymn book. The first one is 2117, The Spirit of God, and 2018, Honor and Praise.
Spirit of God, bright wind, breath that bids life begin, blow as you always do, create us anew. Give us the breath to sing, lifted on soaring wing, held in your hand, born of your wings. Alleluia.
Some practices that we share together in entering into the presence of God. Something that we should do every morning, every day, is to follow the way of Jesus, you know, more of God. Hear the words from the Gospel of Mark where it says, "In the morning, while it was still very dark, Jesus got up, went to a deserted place, and there he prayed." And prayer is listening, mostly. Not just asking, right? Listening to God, resting in God. I hope you've learned that practice. I hope you'll do that practice daily, that you'll continue that. Remember that it is what made Jesus one with God. That connection. Being in the presence. And it's our gift also if we'll continue to practice it. In the Methodist tradition, we call it one of the means of grace, one of the means of staying in connection with God. Let's start by singing this one piece, "Come and Find the Presence." presence. Take a breath. Just breathe for a moment and follow the breath. A gentle breath in and a cleansing breath out. And as we do that, we think about God's creation. How much we need the trees that cleanse the air, that give us the oxygen we breathe. The tree relies on the seed and the planter, the nutrients of the soil, the rain, the sunshine. Without that, we wouldn't have the breath. That's God. That's what we ought to be thankful for. And we rest in that, in the very presence. We think of those who are also taking in the very same breath that we are. We should give thanks for others, that we are one among so many that God calls in a community. God calls us to be one with, to love one another. And it ought to start to bring to mind those who are hurting. Those who feel left out. Those who may be different that we just pass by sometimes. We don't hear their cry. And we stop and we lift up then those times, and those that need healing, some mending. For victims of war and those who perpetrate it. For the victims of gun violence, for a change of heart in the gun lobby and in Congress. For victims of hyperinflation, which brings about uncertainty and fear. For an end to excessive profiteering by the petroleum industry. For the United Methodist Church, as we splinter in the way that we read the Bible and we condemn others, or we create walls and we divide. I just want to alert you, and if you feel the call, rolling Rolling Ridge is going to put on a seminar to help with reconciling ministries. It will be the 23rd of June. It's a webinar from 6:30 to 8:30. Anyone feels called to help lead this church in that direction? For the Boy Scouts of America and their relationship, especially with the United Methodist Church, there will also be a webinar for pastors. How do we continue on in such a wonderful ministry, yet bring healing and responsibility? I hope you'll encourage your pastor, your new pastor, to attend that. For the wonders of Moultonboro United Methodist Church and its future, which is you, and God in you. I also want to lift up Dave Eastwood, who is now home, but is really challenged. For the Jansen family, who spread Barbara's ashes yesterday around Barbara's birch, down by the water, down at Buzzell's Cove. And now I just want to leave the space open for you, that as the Spirit moves, if there's a name or a situation that you want to lift up, we'll do joys in a minute, but at this point, if there's other concerns that are on your heart or mind, either silently or aloud, just share that. Lord, hear our prayer.
My brother Charles in Chicago, who is now in hospice,
Lord, hear our prayers.
He goes peacefully.
God's rolling thunder passing through, right? Paul also wrote, "Rejoice always, pray without ceasing, give thanks in all circumstances, for this is the will of our God in Christ Jesus for you." We take a moment then to be in thanks, to share our gratitude, and especially today for fathers and for your new pastor, Reverend Wilcox, and family that are coming in. I know that they've arrived and have begun to move in and all. Is there someone who would like to share a witness about fathers this morning? Anyone want to share a witness?
Yeah, I do. Yeah.
Good.
Many of you remember Pop, right? Sitting up there at the end. My dad, he loved the Lord so, so dearly. And being brought up in Melrose, Mass, I remember my dad in the choir there in Melrose. And I think probably for some 60 years, without missing one or two Sundays, my dad sang in a choir somewhere, bringing praise to God. If you were the pastor, though, of the church, when it came prayer time, my father, I don't know why he ever did it, Reverend Ed would remember, you could hear my father going through the paperwork of the next piece of music and not paying attention. And it used to drive us nuts. But anyway, that's my dad. I love him dearly. And, quite a guy.
Keep moving, because I think there's a bolt of lightning coming at you. Anyone else have a witness of Dad? She's going to bring you the mic so everyone can hear.
This is back in the 50s and 60s when women really weren't in business or doing anything. And my dad was, I think he quit school at 12 because he had to help support the family. But he always told me, you can do whatever you want to do, and whatever you want to do, I'll support you. Yeah. And I just thought that was great.
An encouragement, yeah, encouraging. Wow. Thank you.
My dad was a great guy. My mother was kind of nuts, and if it wasn't for my father, I'd probably be worse off than I am now. He was always gentle and kind, and when all else failed, he mowed the lawn or shoveled snow, one or the other. But he was a constant in the family, and he would tell us things like, I don't know why you worry all the time, because 99% of what you worry about isn't going to happen, and the 1% that is, we'll take care of it. And I heard that so many times. And he loved the Lord, too, and his big claim to fame is that he had read through the Bible 5 times. We're not sure of his interpretation all the time, but he was a wonderful guy, and he lived to be 99. And my children and my grandchildren were always there in his sight, and he loved them. Ed's also a dad that took 2 boys that had no home and really had very little future, and he did all that he could do for them. Yesterday, Christopher was home. Today, OV will be coming. And so I just want to thank Ed for all that he did for them. And I also want to thank him for working as hard as he can every day to be with me. And I thank God for that.
Amen. Thank you.
I can remember, Murray, I can remember your father every Christmas Eve saying, "Oh, Holy Night." And then you tried to pick it up, and it was a total disaster.
Nothing like wonderful encouragement.
Thanks, Bill. I'll remember that.
You know, not every father's perfect either. My father had some interesting warts, but he had a wonderful side too. He always taught by example that you can do things if you take your time. You know, and you kind of look at it and you figure out how it goes. Don't take a hammer to take it apart or to put it back together again. You know, take your time. And that was something that really stuck with me and really sticks with both my sons and my daughter, too. So that was pretty neat. Wow.
Can I say one more funny?
No.
Daddy.
No. I'm sorry, Bev.
Murray's dad had this huge voice, and he sang right behind me in choir for as many years as I can remember. And one Easter, we were singing, and the words were, "When I fall on my knees with my face to the rising sun," and Murray sang full tilt, "When I fall on my face with my knees to the rising sun," and we're all trying not to laugh, and he's mad as he can be because he doesn't believe us that he said that.
That's good. Anyone else?
Unfortunately, Bev, it's running in the family, and I don't sing the right words to a piece of music. I change it.
Ken.
My dad always had a great saying. He said that before you judge someone, make sure you walk 5 miles in their moccasins.
Is there someone feels moved to share a prayer for dads? Is there someone who feels moved to do that this morning? Remember, it's just from the bottom of your heart. It doesn't have to be. Well, would you? Kate, sure. Thank you. Kate will. Thank you.
And so, Father God, we come before you in gratitude. Thank you for loving dads who have made us laugh and who have taught us well. Thank you for seeing us through difficult dads who suffered in their own pain and perhaps brought that pain into our lives. Thank you for being the place where we can go with that. Thank you for your own fatherhood, for being the one to whom Jesus turned over and over and over again in prayer. Help us also to turn to you in quiet hearts and be strengthened with that same power. God, I thank you for every dad in this room. I thank you for the stories that weren't said today but were held in hearts deeply. And we thank you for all of these things. In your precious name, Holy Father, amen.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you, Kate. Murray, would you share a prayer for the coming of the new pastor this morning?
Yes, gladly.
With gratitude?
Wilcox family, his wife's first name is Tamara, not Tamara, but she wants to be called Tamara. And Reverend Tim, he likes to be referred to as Reverend Tim, so I just share that with you at this point. But as we begin a welcoming for Reverend Tim, let us be in prayer. Loving and ever so gracious God, for all the new beginnings that you placed before us, we give you thanks. We can't do these things alone, God. We need encouragement, and we need the power of your Holy Spirit to be with us. The guidance, yes, it will come from Reverend Tim, and we pray now that the presence of your Holy Spirit will guide him, encourage, and strengthen him as he leads you and me into a new phase of our religious life. May we find the strength, each and every one of us, to do good, to do more, to do more than we've done before. We need to sacrifice for the sake of the church and for the sake of our Lord Jesus Christ. So may the power of the Holy Spirit be upon us, but be upon the family of Reverend Tim. We give you thanks. In Christ's name, amen.
Other thanks that is on your hearts and minds this morning, take a moment and either name them for yourself silently or share them aloud. Let's just take another moment of time of gratitude.
I'm delighted that I got a chance to see so much of my family last week.
Amen.
see my beloved sister and brother-in-law who came all the way over this morning to be here. Thank you. Thank you for your leadership in that too, Sheila. Let us join together in the prayers Jesus taught us, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And let us not fall into temptation, but deliver us from all evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
At this time, I invite the ushers to come down and receive the morning offering. Into wine, sorrow into joy, death into life. So too, take these offerings and transform them from objects into actions. May our gifts become animated expressions of your love for the world. In the name of Jesus Christ we pray, amen.
And all the people said,
amen.
I invite you to be seated. So for me, the main declaration and call of the Christian faith comes from 1 John chapter 4, where it says, Beloved, let us love one another, because love is from God. Everyone who loves is born of God and knows God. Whoever does not love doesn't know God, for God is love. God is love. Let's remain seated and sing a couple of pieces that'll be on the screen up here. I'd just like to take a few minutes and share some of my gratitude and thanks. I want to just start by saying that when we first came here, we had been at the Cape, and it was not a good experience for Linda and me. It was a pretty tough one. Sometimes appointments just don't work out, and Linda got pretty hurt. And though when we got here, we heard some awful, harsh things about your previous pastor, unfortunately, from a few people, which was sad, but you made her feel so welcomed that she came back into church, because she wasn't going to. She was not going to return to church. She'd been hurt so badly. And I have to say, I want to especially express my thanks to the choir. So Linda had never sung in the choir before. She, you know, they would have tryouts for the girls in high school, but not for the boys. So any boy could make it in. And she didn't make it in, so she never felt confident in herself. But thank you, Ashley. And for those who are in the choir that welcomed her and brought her back. And I also want to thank you for the dinners and the prayers and all the kind help as Linda went through chemo for 2 years, too. Made a big difference for us. And so I also want to give thanks that we grew together. One of the things that I was challenged with by the DS when I got here was to try to help bring some healing, because there was a lot of torn and tearing apart, and especially I think it was just over the whole election thing. I mean, I'd hate to have been, well, I was actually taking a little recess there too, so I wasn't caught up quite that much in it, but we were able to do that, and we were able to have some healing come. And I especially give thanks, Diane, for your leadership and staff parish at the time and bringing me in and helping me to understand the congregation more, and I pray that you'll continue to do that. Rich, I know, is already doing that with Reverend Wilcox and all. I give thanks also that for the most part we were able to negotiate some pretty tough waters in the whole question of sexuality, That's tearing the United Methodist Church apart still. And we lost some members over it. And I just have to say to you, sometimes you've got to be willing to do that, that you don't compromise on the love of God. And if some need to leave, you have to not force them out. You don't want anyone to, but that's a choice. Jesus let the rich young man go. Many did not continue to follow Jesus either, and they killed him. And we gained a number over how we were too, how we faithfully walked together. So just remember that. I hope you remember that. I'm especially really thankful for how God worked in leading us to bring Moultonboro Learning Center into this church. One of the challenges I was asked to take on, I think it was almost the first day here, was, okay, Pastor Bob, what are you going to do about the facility next door? What are we going to put in there? And I turned and I said, wait a minute, I just came here. What have you guys been talking about, you know? And it started with really Rich Merkel stepping out to try to help find someone in the nursery. And he thought about going down to, you know, the local daycare and see if anybody wanted some extra, you know, money, time to come in. And he heard, brought the issue in. We rallied around it. And what wonders happened. I mean, to renovate a whole building, to do the work that was needed here, and now to hear little footsteps. You know, I pray that you will continue that. Again, we did lose some over that issue, too. Some really didn't want that to happen, and we've lost a few people because of it. And yet it was the right thing to do. I believe it was the right thing to do, and we did it faithfully. Kate started a Wednesday evening contemplative group. Very thankful for that. I pray that that will continue. And we weathered COVID. And especially because of Shane and taking on the technical challenges, but it was, you answered the call of God to do that and got us online and all, and the music team kept us going, and especially outdoors at the high school. Yeah, amazing. Ashley, thank you for all that you did in that too, especially the emails that went out of encouragement along that time and all. And I want to thank you all for being there for me when I needed you. Jesus said in the Gospel of John that they may be one as we are one. That you be the glory, which it means the unspoken manifestation of God. That's what the glory is. The unspoken manifestation of God that's in me, Jesus says, that it would be in you also, that you may be one as we are one, and that all may be one. Be the model of harmony in the community. That's my prayer from Moultonboro United Methodist Church, that you be one and you show it. We went from two services to one, and that was because of lots of things, but it is demonstrating the unity and the harmony, I think. And you may need to go back to two. And that's not the worst thing that can happen, but it really shows something when you can have, because when I got here, I was told there were two congregations, and don't you dare mix the two. And it's not even funny. It really was. It's kind of sad. But we've come together, and I pray that even if you do go back to two, that you find ways to stay together as one congregation, one body, right? That means harmony, not necessarily everyone agrees on everything, right? Right? There's still different keys on the keyboard. I also pray that you'll break out of the slump of COVID. It's time to become active again as a church. It's time to get out into the community again and do things, and not just fundraisers, right? It's time to rally around something. One of the things that's happening in the high school is this Choose Love program. They had a little seminar this week, and no one from this church was there. We tried to get involved in it just before COVID hit, and it didn't get picked up. I pray that you'll do something like that, where you take the love of God, you put it into action. As you said, it's love in action, right? pick an effort. I know that you just gave out scholarships, and that was just Sandra Ringelstein saying, you know what, that's something that's on my heart, and she started that ministry. If there's something on your heart, start a ministry. You know, and you don't have to be on a whole committee and do it all year, but find something. Find something that you can lead others in at least once a year that's really in the community. And we've talked a lot about small groups. Small groups. And to be in a small group, not just because you need it, but be there for somebody else who needs it. Somebody else is hurting. They need you to have the small group so they can find a place. The small group on Tuesday mornings was as much for me over the last year as I think it was for those in the group. So don't just think, well, I don't really need it. Think about someone else who does and be there. I give thanks that Linda started a covenant group and started to bring women together, right? Small group, accountability and encouragement. That's Methodism, accountability and encouragement. So that's what you're doing, holding each other accountable and encouraging each other. That's what small groups are about. And in that, you grow in Christ and you live out Christ. Again, I hope you'll, I know Janine Royer has been going down on Tuesday mornings after our small group, and she goes down and reads to the kids, she brings puppets, she sings. Join Janine in ministries to Moultonboro Learning Center. And don't do it because you think that way they'll come to church. Do it because it's the right thing to do. Do it so you show them Christ. They come to feel it and experience it, and then they'll want it. Do it with no expectations except to show the love of God. I know one other challenge in this church is leadership. It's a transient church, and some people have been in leadership and live here in the community, have been here a long time and are getting tired. So you're going to have to figure out how to do such dynamics here, right? Who's going to lead during the summer and who's going to lead during the winter? Or, you know, in Boy Scouts, we had two deep leadership. So maybe you have to do that. So it's tag team things going on. Think about that and help your new pastor do that, because it's going to be challenging. Some people are already tired and in need. Darlene Fritz has had to go back to the company there, and so she's really overwhelmed. And so finances, and thankful that Michelle, who's sitting, Michelle, will you raise your hand? Just people, can you just stand just for a moment, because not everybody knows. This is Michelle Kouris, and she is our office manager. I don't mean to put you on the line too much, but I have been in the Air Force, in industry, and in the church, and Michelle's the best assistant I've ever had. I'm not kidding. Because of her attitude, her can-do, she has stepped up to take on part of those finances, and someone's going to have to come along and start helping Darlene out. So if you have any inclination, any sense of that call, please rise up to that. And then once again, it all hinges on whether you stop and center yourself. You know, whether you really breathe the Spirit. It can't just be about coming to church on Sunday morning. It's about the practice during the week. Slow down, you know. Stop and smell the roses along the way. You know? I pray that you'll do that and that you'll do it together. And I hope, Kate, that Wednesday nights start again, if they can. And that be another opportunity to do that. So remember that God is love, that the kingdom of God is within, and it's all around, that heaven is now, that eternal life is a way to live life now, to live in the eternals, right? In the sense of beauty and forgiveness and patience and love of one another. Worship God, worship the ways of Jesus, not the Bible. Remember that the Bible is a collection of stories that progress. It contradicts itself. It is not taken literally. It has to be read literarily. It has to be brought into the context of today. And that God gives us a mind and a heart to step out from it. Walk in the ways of Christ. Always. Don't argue and try to convince. Less about God and more of God, right? And do that with everyone and anyone. Welcome all who come into the doors. I want to leave you with one final poem from Mary Oliver. It's called Logos. Logos. Remember, Logos is the way. It's the way of God, which becomes human in Jesus so he can show us, right? I love this. So why worry about the loaves and the fishes? If you say the right word, the wine expands. If you say them with love and the felt ferocity of that love, the fish explode into many. Imagine him speaking, and don't worry about what is reality or what is plain or what is mysterious. If you were there, it was all those things. If you can imagine it, it is all those things. Eat, drink, be happy, accept the miracle, accept too each spoken word spoken with love. So one last time, we're going to sing this wonderful piece for you, Heavenly Sunshine.
Walking in sunlight, all of my journey over the mountains, through the deep veil. Jesus has said, I'll never forsake thee. Promised in sunlight, never can fail. Sunlight, heavenly sunlight, flooding my soul with glory divine. Hallelujah, I am rejoicing, singing his praises. Jesus is mine. Shadows around me,
shadows
above me,
never could see my Savior and guide. He is the light,
he is the light,
in him is no darkness,
in him no darkness.
Ever I'm walking close to his side,
heavenly sun. Sunlight flooding my soul with glory divine. Hallelujah, I am rejoicing, singing his praises.
Jesus is mine.
Jesus is mine.
Yes, Jesus is mine.
Jesus is mine.
Hallelujah.
Jesus is mine.
No, Jesus is mine.
Jesus is mine. In the bright sunlight, ever I'm walking,
pressing my way to vengeance and love, singing his praises.
Gladly I'm walking. Walking in sunlight, sunlight of love, heavenly sunlight, flooding my soul. Jesus is mine. Jesus is mine. Jesus. Jesus is mine.
Yep. Several months ago when Bob was thinking
about... Wait, before we go there. What? Someone asked me this morning what I'll miss the most. What I miss the most is singing together. And I have really enjoyed, incredibly, singing with you, Murray, and the group. It's been amazing, absolutely amazing. Lots of fun.
I asked him this morning, I said, Bob, what are you going to miss most? And he says, it's going to be the music and the singing. And I can understand that, and I appreciate that.
And all of you, too. But the small group of choir and all, right, Wednesday, Thursday nights and all, yeah.
Bob actually has shared all the thoughts that I was going to extend out once again to you. But when Linda and Bob first came here, they really did have a challenge. And Pastor Bob and Linda, they stood up to it. You know, the life of a pastor is not always the easiest thing for anyone. For Pastor Bob having to go through the 2 years of Linda's chemo, that takes a toll on any human being. And then with her passing, and if that wasn't enough, Bob's mom passed away, his sister-in-law passed away, and actually Boomer, his dog passed away too. So when you put all those ingredients into a human being's life, it ain't easy, folks. It's not easy. Now you throw in COVID. Well, we don't need to share anything more like that. But what I want to say simply, you know, if there's nothing else that we as a congregation and a faith community have learned, it's two things. And he mentioned them already. Love one another. He tried to put that into our brains. The question is, did you receive it? And the other piece, Bob, is, you know, we are in the kingdom. This is the kingdom of God here and now. And I pray that as we go through the coming years, we'll find greater ways to love one another, putting our differences aside and love one another, realizing that we are a part today of God's kingdom. Well, all that being said, Rich isn't going to let Bob off the hook yet, so you've got something else, I think.
Nah. So it's been interesting 5 years and a tough 5 years for Bob. But I think before we start, Bob, let's do something that you do a lot. Take a deep breath, a cleansing breath. Breath in and a breath out. We appreciate this is an emotional time for you. So Bob spent a lot of time talking about all the things that he's thankful for from the church, and we thought we would give you a chance to say a few things that you might be thankful for what he's done for us for the last 5 years. So does anybody have anything they'd like to say to Bob with regards to his tenure at MUMC?
I am thankful that the first time I walked in this church, you said, God is love, and you had me totally with that. And I thank you. It has changed my life.
I am more fully who I think God meant me to be because of the opportunities you gave me.
Way, Bob, that you have pulled us together in community and taught us to put love first.
I'm very thankful, Bob, for your... Sorry.
I'm thankful that you've always held up and stuck to your guns no matter how bad the obstacles were against you at times, and you presented so many ideas and so many beliefs and understandings that, at least for me, have been extremely beneficial, so I can't imagine it hasn't been for others as well. So thank you.
Merci beaucoup. Du fond de mon cœur. You want the translation? Thank you so much from the bottom of my heart.
Bob, I thank you for helping me.
I've been a
Methodist for over 50 years, and I've seen a lot of pastors come and go, trust me. And I want to say, some of your sermons were some of the best I've heard, and I take it home and think about it, and that's a blessing. That's such a blessing to hear the word and take it back. No nodding. And I also want to thank you for the Tuesdays, and we could say Bible study, but it wasn't just Bible study. It was a study in our humanity and our faith, not just what the Bible says, but how we think. And that was such a blessing as well. Thank you.
Bob, I just want to thank you for helping me grow in my faith and giving me some confirmation of some of my own beliefs. And it's really helped me a lot. I thank you.
Bob. Worked together somewhat, and we didn't have to get all skimmed up and everything. We just talk sometimes, and it's been hard for me when people go different places. He's going to go other places. And that's my wanting to tell you that how much you have done for this church, even though I've been here, it's many, many, many years. And your wife was really super, and I really miss her. And so in that case, I just want to say, this church and find a good place, and someone here can do that. We can each do it. Let it be what I want.
And this is a sneak attack, but thank you for coming, and I thank you for bringing Linda. She meant so much to me, and she was there all the time. I mean, all the crap that happened in the past 5 years, and every day I could count on either a call or a email from Linda. She, truly wonderful, and I thank you for bringing her to us right when I needed it, really. Thanks.
And Bob, when Marshall retired and we looked for a church, we looked all around, and then we came here, and we just resonated. He and I both resonated with your messages and your service and your sermons and everything. And Linda, I loved Linda. That was just a balm to my soul at that time. And we just thank you with all of our hearts, and we love you.
Well, this is it, Bob. I want, as chairperson, co-chair of the Ad Council, I want to personally thank you for the diversity of you bringing your business head, your spiritual head, to this congregation and pulling us together and getting all these accomplishments. It's amazing the things we've done in 5 years, and it's just a good track record, and I wish you well in retirement. And on behalf of the council, I want to thank you very much.
You know, sometimes it's hard to take compliments, but if you reflect them back to God and you realize it's only because it's God in our lives that enables us to do these things, then we can be co-creators, right? So it's a blessing, and thank you. Thank you.
As we were approaching today, Bob said he would not do, he didn't want to be part of a ceremony. He didn't want to be part of a process. He just wanted to
say right off into the sunset.
So thank you all for your thoughts, your prayers, your comments. Sure.
This is my sister. My dear sister.
I've got a good loud voice.
They could hear online, Debbie. We're online, so that's why you have to use
Really? Yes. You had him as a pastor. And I, thank goodness for technology, if COVID gave us anything, it gave us the technology so I could participate online and watch and learn, just as all of you have. And I also got it personally from him because I could ask a question and he could explain it to me. And you had a wonderful pastor, but I got one heck of a wonderful, wonderful brother. And my sister-in-law, she was a saint. She was going through her cancer. I was going through mine. And she and I would talk every single day, email every single day, and send little messages every single day. And she was the light of my life when I was going through it, and vice versa. So I guess we're all blessed. And God is love. And we thank you for teaching us that.
Breathe. I've said my piece. I need to shut up.
So there'll be a reception downstairs in the social hall after church. But while everybody's here, we had a couple of presents we wanted to give up. And it's interesting today. We've heard a number of times that God is love. So give him a minute. So, oh, I rap well, I bag well.
Hold that.
Yes, so if you would take that out. And as you know, Bob has done lots of work on cars. He's done lots of work on parsonages around his house. So we found this. We wanted to give him some things that would remember him about the church. And this just seemed to fit with God is love.
Oh, that's cool. Oh, wow. Look at that.
It says
artist is amazing what he does with the old tool.
It says love.
Oh, now I see. I thought it was a boat. I told him it the wrong. It says love.
I thought it was on its side.
That's cool.
Maybe it's an algebraic equation on its side.
Yeah, that's right. Well, it's what does it say backwards when you turn the Beatles album back? No, that's fantastic. Wow, that's very thoughtful. Thank you. Wow.
And the other thing we had, since so much of this town is the lake, and so much of this church is tied to the town and the lake, and since you live on the lake, we thought we would give you this as a remembrance of the church and the area.
See, Debbie, you can just rip the paper up, remember, you know, you don't have to.
And I have to thank Jane Estes for wrapping.
My sister was always the one who said, you can reuse the paper if you do it gently, right?
I had a lot of ribbon before instead.
We stopped wrapping gifts for the kids, you know, when they got into high school, and one, and I think I told you this, when is when the Magi come? Epiphany, yeah. So I was preaching about that, and I turned to my daughter and said, see, they brought gifts, and it doesn't say anywhere that they wrapped them. thank you. I've been looking at, wanting to get one of the, that's not wonderful. Thank you. And we're way up here, right? We're way up here.
Yeah, I really debated about trying to put the church on the map, but I was afraid I'd screw it up.
Thank you. I've looked at these. I've coveted one of these, so this is fantastic. Thank you so much. Thank you.
And then lastly, there's some, just a card for from the church.
Congratulations on your retirement, and best wishes for all the happiness and contentment you deserve in the years to come. Your Moultonboro United Methodist congregation. Thank you, and there's quite a sum of cash in here. I tell people that ministry is about this kind of connection, and what I really miss, besides the singing, is that time when we are together, and especially when we're in deep need and our hearts connect, and we can be there for one another, and we can be there for others, and we can share the joys, and whether it's a dinner, or it's a fair, or it's out helping clean somebody's yard or something together, that's what it's all about, isn't it? And I will certainly find ways to continue to do that, but you'll be in my thoughts and prayers, and my thanks, my gratitude, of being that connection throughout. So thank you. Thank you very much. Appreciate that.
So as we prepare to send Pastor Bob off into the sunset, we still have to keep Bob happy. We've got a couple more songs we want to sing. And so if you want, let's stand. The first one we're going to be doing is Lord, You Have Come to the Lakeshore.
By our love, by
Yes, they'll know we are Christians by our love.
Well, as I've said for 19 years of ministry, if you go in Christ, Christ will go in you. And if you go in Christ and Christ goes in you, others will see too. And this will happen. It'll just keep replicating, right? Go in Christ, and Christ will go in you. Thank you for the opportunity to be in ministry with you. And I pray that you'll continue in the same, but remembering that I'm wearing my shoes as I go out. And the new pastor brings in his or her own shoes. And so give him some room and find ways to come together and journey down maybe a slightly different path, but do it in love, and Christ will be with you, and you'll be the light in the community. Amen?
Amen.
We join together and we sing our benediction, remembering that we sing it to God, but we turn to one another because we're singing it to each other too. It's God's song to us as we go.
Peace through all our trials. May he shelter us from harm and keep us safe and warm as we go along. May the love of Jesus go with you as we part and go our separate ways. May we be more like him with a love that shines within. Father, hear our prayers. Amen.
And the celebration continues downstairs.